Hello, I'm Eugene, and today I'm going to go over 1-1-1-5 target 8, or as I call it, the dartboard problem. First, I'll read. Aidan and Carson are playing a game in which they throw 3 darts at a dartboard and tally the score. The white area is worth 1 point, the blue area is worth 5 points, and the red area is worth 10 points. The dartboard has 3 concentric circles with ray 4, 8, and 12. The innermost, middle, and outermost regions formed by these circles are colored red, blue, and white, respectively. In one round, Carson landed all 3 of the darts in the blue area. Assuming that Aiden hasn't thrown any of his darts yet, and that all of his darts will land somewhere in the dartboard uniformly at random, what is the probability that Aiden will score higher than Carson? Express your answer as a common fraction. Whew, that's a lot of text. I also see a lot of circle stuff. Might as well draw a diagram so I know what's going on. So 3 concentric circles. Concentric basically means same center. 1 radius 4, 1 radius 8, 1 radius 12. Distance between these edges is 4. Also, time to label the regions. Now it's time to think about what ways Aiden could beat Carson, but first we gotta figure out what Carson got so we know what to beat. Carson scored 3 times in blue, that means Carson scored 15 points, and 15 is a score to beat. So now it's time to think about what ways Aiden could beat 15. Red seems like the largest scoring area in terms of number of points, not area though. So maybe we can do casework on the red area because the red is the bigger factor in score. So if Aiden scores 3 reds, that's a 30, we're good. Aiden scores 2 reds and somewhere else, 2 reds is good because that's 20. 1 red and 2 others, Aiden's currently at 10, needs to beat 15. If he does 2 whites, he's only gonna get 12. That's less than 15. But if he scores a blue, he's already at 15 and then he gets 1 more. So the only way for 1 red to fail is red, white, white. But other than that, he's successful. And finally, if he scores no reds, then the highest other scoring area would be in the blue area, but that would only lead to 15 points. That would tie Carson, but not enough to beat him. So that would be a fail. So now it's time to think about how likely Aiden would land in these 3 areas. So first off, total area is going to be 144 pi because it's a dartboard of radius 12. Red area is going to be 16 pi. White area is going to be the entire dartboard, but there's the inner side that isn't white, so we're going to have to subtract that out. Inner part that's not right has radius 8, so 144 pi minus 64 pi, that's going to lead to 80 pi. Then we can find the probability now. Probability of getting red, that's going to be 16 pi over 144 pi, or 1/9. Probability of getting in the white area, that's 80 pi over 144 pi, that's going to be 5/9. And blue is everywhere else, so that's going to be 3/9 or 1/3. All right, but that's 1 dart. Now you need 3. And there are a lot of cases to consider, but it doesn't seem as though there's a lot of failure points to consider, or at least it's a lot easier to count that way. So basically, if we figure out the areas at which Aiden fails and then subtract that from 1, which is certainty, we can find the probability of what he wants. All right, so probability of no red in 1 dart, that's going to be 8/9, since the probability of red is 1/9. So probability of no reds, that's going to be 8/9 cubed, and that's going to be 512 over 729. The only other failing option is red, white, white, or any order of that. 3 possible ways to order because of the placement of R, so you have to multiply by that 3. Then 3 times 1/9 times 5/9 squared, and that's going to be equal 75 over 729. Then you add them together to get to the probability of the unwanted section, is going to equal 587 over 729. So the probability that Aiden score is higher than Carson, 729 over 587, divide that over 729, and we get a total of 142 over 729. Whew, that was a pretty involved problem. Didn't realize that a dartboard problem will be pretty long and has so much going on.
Hi, everybody. This is Tim. Hope you're enjoying our videos. If so, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, turn on notifications, all that sort of thing. But what I'd really want to invite you to do is to send us an email at media@mathleague.org. Tell us which problems you'd like to see us cover next in our video series. Take care and see you in the next video.